Hey, Jordan here. As a product designer, I've developed a specific process that I use every time I need to make a UI color palette. It's efficient, repeatable, and it works every time. So today I thought I'd show you the 5 steps I run through and give you a few extra tips along the way for working with color. First, let's talk about what we're gonna need. Almost all UI color palettes have just 3 categories of colors: brand colors, supporting colors, and neutrals. Brand colors come from the business. You'll have 1, maybe 2 brand colors that you'll be working with, and you'll kind of use them throughout the UI as splashes of color, and it will determine what the feel of the site is. A good example of this is Facebook's blue, which makes their app feel blue even though it's mostly grays. You'll use brand colors on things like buttons, links, navigation, and icons. Supporting colors are used throughout the interface in key places where you need to draw attention or communicate something to the user using color. These will be used less often than brand colors. You'll only see them in certain places like error messages or confirmations or informational dialogues. Most of your app is going to be made up of colors from the neutrals category because almost everything in a UI is some form of gray. Think text, backgrounds, border colors, and secondary buttons. Okay, let's start the process of building out a color palette for these 3 categories. Step number 1 is to find a starting point. We don't need to pick a bunch of colors right off the bat. We're going to pick 1 color and then expand out from there in a systematic way. More often than not, this starting point is going to be your brand color, because that's the one that's most important and least likely to change. The good news is that in most cases, you'll just be handed this color because it's often decided on outside of this whole interface design process when the company is putting together their branding package. Like if we were building an app for Facebook, for example, our base color would be that Facebook blue. If you don't have a brand color or any starting point, you're gonna need to pick one. You're gonna need a good middle color, one that your lighter and darker shades will be based on. There's no real scientific way to do this, but here are a couple good rules of thumb. It's usually gonna be in this upper right section of the color picker, and it's usually going to be a shade that would work well as a button background. If you need inspiration, there's lots of places to find that online. A couple of my favorites are HueMint.com and ColorHunt.co. For the palette we're building today, let's say our brand color is this purple. Before we move on to step 2, let's talk about one little thing that will help this whole process a lot. Most design programs will default to using hex values for colors, but when making a color palette, you should use HSB instead of hex or RGB. The H in HSB stands for hue, which is the color. It's a number from 1 to 365, which makes sense because it goes all the way around the color wheel. S stands for saturation, which is how intense the color is on a scale from 0 to 100. And B stands for brightness, which means how much black or white you're adding to the color, again on a scale from 0 to 100. HSB will give us much finer control over our colors in a more understandable way, and it's also going to help us out in a few specific places in the following steps. Okay, let's move on to step 2. Next, we're going to pick our supporting colors. Remember, these are the colors that we're going to use in a few specific places in the interface where we need to draw attention or communicate something to the user. I like to have at least the following 4 colors in a UI. Green for success messages or other positive confirmations. Orange or yellow for warnings. Red for dangerous situations like a form error. And blue for neutral informational messages. Supporting colors need to feel like they go along with your brand color. A really simple example of this is if your brand color is really saturated and your supporting colors are really desaturated, the UI might end up feeling a little odd or disconnected. To avoid this, just pay attention to your HSB numbers. Make sure saturation and brightness stay close to your base color. I like to keep it within 5 or 10 away. Then you can adjust the hue however you want. Let's go with these 4 supporting colors for our palette. Now in step 3, we're going to make a bunch of shades. Our colors are going to be used in all kinds of different places throughout the UI, so we're going to need more than just a dark, medium, and light. We'll probably want 5 to 10 shades. So here's the process I like to follow. Lay out 9 blocks. 9 is a good number because it's easy to divide up, as you'll see in a minute. Label them 100 to 900. And we use hundreds like this in part to allow us to easily add half steps later if we want. Put the color you've already chosen in the middle spot at 500. So let's start with our brand purple. Now we're gonna start picking shades, but here is the trick for finding them. Imagine a line that starts at the top left corner of the color picker and goes to the bottom right corner, passing through your base color. The secret is to pick your shades along this arc. The first shades we're going to be picking are the lightest and darkest shades out at the ends. If you need a starting point, try a dark shade around 90 to 100 saturation and 20 to 30 brightness, and a light shade around 5 to 10 saturation and 95 to 100 brightness. But also think about where it's going to be used. The darkest shade of a color is usually used for text, and your lightest shade will probably be used for a tinted background. An alert component is a good example that combines both of these use cases, so it can be a great place to pick these colors. Now we have two gaps. Let's pick the colors right in the middle of the gaps at 300 and 700. Our lightest shade is here on the color picker, and our 500 shade is here. So let's pick this middle point between them on the arc for 300. And we'll do the same for 700. Now we have four more holes remaining in the scale. Let's fill those using the same approach. Once that's done, we filled out a full scale, and now we just need to do the same process with our other colors. Step four is to create your neutrals. Pick a middle gray, and you guessed it, follow the same process to come up with a scale. Keep in mind that you're still going to follow the arc from the top left corner to the bottom right corner, but this time the curve will go in the opposite direction because you're desaturating quite a bit to stay in the grays. Your darker color will also stay further over to the left to keep it from becoming too saturated. Okay, now we've got a set of colors and shades all picked out. The fifth and final step is to test them out to see if we need to make any tweaks. Something I like to do is put all the scales in a row and then squint my eyes or blur the layers to make sure each scale has the same range going from light to dark. You can see in this palette that we're making that the line is a little squiggly, it's not really even. And that means that when we swap out colors in the UI, like for example switching out a background from yellow 200 to a blue 200, it won't look cohesive. So let's fix that by adjusting some of these shades. Now we can start plugging these colors into our UI designs. Look for answers to questions like, do you have all the color options you need? Does it look aesthetically pleasing? Do the colors feel like they fit together? And does it pass color contrast checkers? Actually using your colors with your particular designs in your particular project will help you quickly see any adjustments that you need to make. Use tools, especially for things like accessibility, but also trust your eyes. For example, I'm noticing that our green feels a little too saturated, almost neon, compared to our other colors, so I'm going to bring down the saturation a bit on that scale. In the future, don't be afraid to keep iterating. Just try to avoid adding too many new shades if you can help it. Tweak what you have instead of creating a ton of new shades. You don't want to be deciding between 70 different options. Try to stick to a maximum of 10 shades. Once testing is done, we should end up with a pretty balanced, cohesive set of colors and shades with plenty of options for our UI. Now, if you want to dig really deep into colors, we are making a product designer's field guide for colors. It's got a bunch of stuff like places to find color inspiration, recommendations for tools for things like automating some of the shading process or checking color contrast for accessibility, a tutorial on how to make dark modes, tips for handing off to developers, and a Figma file with example color palettes. You can go to uxtools.co/shop/color to learn more. But I hope this tutorial helps you out. Feel free to come back to it anytime you need to make another UI color palette. And be sure to share in the comments if you have any other tips for working with color. Next, you can watch this video where I critique a real app page, including talking about color, and do a little redesign.